So before going to the topic, I will just give some idea what will be the next topics. Like some 6-7 lecture, what will be your syllabus? So we have seen already scalar valued function and vector valued function. In vector valued function we have seen one parameter, and then we will see two parameter also. So one parameter will give something like curve, and this one will give some surface. So can anyone give the one parameter curve example?
R vector.
Yes. Yeah, can you repeat what you are saying?
R cos theta, R sin theta.
R cos theta, R sin theta. What is R and what is theta? See, like if we have some curve, x square plus y square, last class we have seen like this, x square plus y square equal to 1 in the parametric form. We can take x equal to something cos t, y equal to sin t. So this is the parametric representation of this same curve, x square plus y square equal to 1. In terms of the function, it is a vector valued function where t goes to cos t comma sin t. So that one parameter representation we have seen. So this is one example, t goes to cos t. So here t is the parameter and it is only single parameter. Like someone is saying about cos theta and sin theta, so if we'll take that one, r cos theta and r sin theta. So this is the example of two parameter. Here the parameters are r and theta. That means function of r comma theta is, and it is a vector because it is taking two values. Can you give me an example of a function from a scalar? Any example of a scalar? Scalar valued function. Like fx goes to x square, or f of xy goes to x plus y. So these are example of a scalar valued function. Here f of t equal to cos t comma sin t, if you write in the form of function. So this is the function, f of t goes to this one. Here f of r comma theta is this one, r cos theta comma. So definitely this is a only one parameter here, and here two parameter means like two variable. So if the domain is only R, then it will represent in two dimension, it will represent curve, and if it is R comma theta, it will represent something like surface in two parameter. We'll see two parameter also. Scalar we have seen, vector also we have seen. We have seen how to find limit, continuity, differentiability and all. So one parameter I define, I will repeat again. Two parameter also I will define. Some surface we will take and we will try to convert into the parametric form. So once we will know this, then we will define some integration. So far, whatever integration we have seen how to do integration over interval a comma b. That is Riemann integration from a to b of some function fx dx. We have seen the integration over rectangle or some region in two dimension. So we got some multiple double integral, we got something f of x comma y. This is over region, suppose that region is R, So depending on this r, we will find the limit. So this double integration also we have seen, and we have seen region in 3D, and triple integration also we have seen. So suppose that region is V, then the triple integral over V of some function f of x comma y comma z dx comma y comma z, we don't know which order. So we have seen, see, over interval what will be the integration, over region, two dimension region, we have seen the multiple integration, this double integral, and then triple integral also we have seen. So now two more integral I want to define. One is over this curve, another is over this surface. So like next some 5 and 6 class, I will define integration over curve, not over the interval, integration over the curve, and then I will define the integration over the surface. So now what the next topic will come, first we will define this parametric representation of the curve. With the help of this parametric, how we will define the integration over curve, we will see, and how the integration is defined over surface, that we will see. So we will see the integration over curve, and we will see the integration over surface. Once we will have this thing, then we will see what is the relation between these two, like integration over curve and integration over surface, under what condition both are equal. And then we will see this one also, this double integral and this integration over curve, under what condition they are equal. Similarly, this surface integral and volume integral, under what condition they are equal. So three equality will do, and these three are three theorem. One is called Green theorem, one is Stokes, and one is divergence theorem. So once we'll able to do this, then your syllabus will finish. So in your syllabus, first I have to define, like, whatever left, what is the integration over curve and what is the integration over surface, then relation between this, like curve integration related to the double integral, there is a theorem, and surface integration related to this volume or this triple integral, that is called divergence theorem, and then relation between this curve integral and surface is called Stokes theorem. So all three we will see. First we will see how to define, and then we will see the relation, and then something like Stokes theorem. This one is divergence theorem, so we will see, and this one is the Green's theorem. So all will come one by one. So before going to this, we need some background. Background means how to define this parametric equation. So first I started with one parameter, then I will start second, like two parameter, that means curve and surface is done, then some few terminology, and after that we will define line integral, surface integral, and then relation this all three, this Green's theorem, Stokes theorem, and divergence theorem. So three theorem, and these two integral I have to define, and before that this, how to deal this one parameter. We have seen how to find the length of the curve, here how to find the area of the surface, it is equivalent to like length in curve. So all we'll see some few term, like what is divergence, what all those things. So this all will go simultaneously. This is scalar will also come, vector will also see. So here also we have to see one, so we'll see one more thing. There is one operator that we have seen, the del operator. So what this del operator will do, it will convert, if you apply over vector, it will convert to the scalar, if you apply over scalar, it will become vector. So that also we'll see how to convert vector to scalar or scalar to vector by this del operator. So I think this summary is clear to everyone, what topics will come. First one parameter, then equivalent to that two parameter. Once these two will finish, then we'll see this rule, how to convert a scalar to vector or vector to scalar by using this del operator. After that, I will define this integration over curve, that is called line integral, then integration over surface, that name is surface integral, and then relation between these all four, curve, surface, and this double and triple. Now this parametric equation, last class we have seen this one parameter, this equation you have to find x equal to some function of t, y equal to some function of t, and if you write in the vector form, then you can write like x comma y, x is f of t and y equal to g of t. So this is vector valued function in R2, it is taking two values. So like these are the example we have seen. This is the parametric equation of which curve? It will represent a circle with center 0, 0 and radius 2. This one represents hyperbola. This is the parametric, only one parameter t is here. Then we have seen this, what is the parametric? There are a lot of parametric representation is possible. If it is given, then you will use that one. If it is not given, then you can find any one to do the problem. Similarly, we have seen if suppose line passing through 2 point, then what will be the parametric representation in 2 dimension and even 3 dimensional. So this is one parameter only. And then we have seen how to find the length of that curve. If that curve is represented by this parametric equation x equal to ft and y equal to gt. So this example we have seen already, and we found the length of this curve x equal to r cos t or y equal to r sin t, that is the circle, and we got answer 2 pi r. So that we did in the last class about one parameter. Okay, this tangent and all we will come later. First I will define 2 parameter, then I will define how to find tangent in 1 parameter and how to find tangent and normal in 2 parameter. That I will come to later. First move to the, so this one I am skipping for the timing, but I will come back to this later. So there are 3 tangent you have to see. So I'm just going back to here. So one is how to find the tangent and normal for 1 parameter curve, how to find the tangent and normal for 2 parameter, that is surface. And then how to find, this is the part of vector. Vector have 2, means in your syllabus 1 parameter and 2 parameter only. So we'll see tangent and normal here, we'll see tangent and normal here, and we'll see tangent and normal in the scalar also. So now moving to the 2 parameter. So like there we have only 1 parameter, that parameter is t. Here I am denoting that parameter by u and v, and this is also a vector valued function, this u comma v. So this x component is f u comma v, some function of u comma v. This is y component and this is z component, or you can write this is like f u comma v I cap plus g u comma v j cap and plus h u comma v k cap, like in ij cap notation also. So it is a continuous vector valued function. That means these are all continuous. And we have seen how to or define the continuity in vector valued. This is just component wise. So these are all continuous over the region R in UV plane, because there are 2 parameters. So definitely range is something, this U and V will belongs to some region, not like in the interval. And it is 1 to 1. So why we are taking 1 to 1 of this interior on R? Like we have defined this length of this curve. So when we are calculating the length, this is the parametric equation and it is continuous and it is not simultaneously 0, because we want that length will cover only one time. Like we are moving, so it will cover only one time. So we will not repeat the same path again. So to avoid this thing, that means this 2 parameter surface will not intersect itself. So for that, this 1 to 1 is needed. Then this is the, then if it is 1 to 1 in this interior region R, then we will call this range of R, that this is the domain, this u comma v, and this range is f u comma v, this g u comma v, and h u comma v. These are in the range. That is called the surface defined by this equation 1. And in the parametric equation form, you can write like x equal to f u comma v, y equal to g u comma v, equal to u comma v. So here 2 parameters are there. Like in the single parameter that represents a curve, in 2 parameter it will represent a surface. So the question is, how to find the parametric equation for this. So if z equal to 0, what it will be? Here it is given z from 0 to 1. So at z equal to 0, what is the z equal to square root of x square plus y square will represent at z equal to 0?
Point.
Which point? at z equal to 0, the value of x will come 0 and y will also come 0. So that means it is a point 0 comma 0 comma 0. When z equal to 1, it will represent square root of x square plus y square equal to 1. That is nothing but a
Circle.
circle center at 0 comma 0 and radius 1. So with the help of this, I am just drawing the picture of this. So in the three dimension, okay, let me draw like this. So if this is x axis, this is y axis, and this one is the z axis. So at z equal to 0, when z equal to 0, it is a point. This is the point. X, y, all are 0. At z equal to 1, it will represent a circle with center 0 comma 0 and radius 1. Like z equal to 1 is this height, it is a circle. So just try to imagine this is the circle at height z equal to 1. And when suppose z equal to 1, then the circle radius is 1. Suppose z equal to half, that circle size will reduce. So once z will move from the top to bottom, like z equal to 1 to 0, that circle radius will slowly goes to 0. And when z equal to 0, that will become a point. That circle will shrink to a point from z equal to 1 to 0. So the picture of this will look like something like this. So it is a cone up like this. So these all are circle, but slowly this all circle will reduce and it will become 0 point. So this is the cone. So are you able to visualize this cone? So now the question is, what is the parameterization of this? So can anyone give the parametric, like what will be x, y and z? So now I want to find the parametric equation of this. X equal to something, y equal to something, and z equal to something. So for x square and y square, can I take x equal to something cos t, y equal to something sin t or something? Or x equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta, can I take?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so suppose I am taking x equal to r cos theta. So r and theta are two parameter here. Y equal to also r sin theta. So if x equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta, then what is the value of z from this? Because z equal to square root of x square plus y square.
R.
R. So this is the parametric representation of the same cone with two parameters. So what are the parameter here? R and theta. So these are the parameter. So now what is the domain of for r and what is the domain for theta? Like r will lie from where to where and theta will lie from where to where?
R 0 to 1.
Yes, because r is equal to z, so clearly r is from 0 to 1. So here r will start from 0, it will go up to 1, and theta
0 to 2 pi.
Yeah, because theta is the part of circle, so it will go from 0 to 2 pi. Even circle radius is, even this circle, whatever circle radius, even half, 1/3, even 0 also, but that theta will rotate from 0 to 2 pi in order to generate this cone. So this is the final answer. This is the parametric representation of this cone, not the solid cone, the surface part of the cone. So in two parameter, it will represent a surface. We will define integration over surface later, but this is the answer.
Sir?
Yes.
That will be 0 to pi, na?
Why 0 to pi?
2 pi.
If you rotate 360, then only this surface of this cone will cover. See, at z equal to 1, if it is only this x square plus y square equal to 1, then theta from 0 to 2 pi. Right? For this circle. And here, what is the difference here? The only that the radius of this circle is z, is like z. Here, x square plus y square equal to z square. If z is fixed, that is the radius. And z is r. R is running from 0 to 1. Now the next question. Find the parameterization of this sphere. Sphere means like not the solid sphere. It is the surface of this sphere. X square plus y square plus z square equal to a square. Like if we are in two dimension, like if it is x square plus y square equal to a square, it will represent this circle not this disk. This part is not cover. Only the boundary will cover. Similarly, this x square plus y square plus z square equal to a square, it will cover only the boundary of this sphere. That means it is not a solid sphere. So the question is, what will be the parametric representation of this, like in terms of parameter?
X equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta.
Yeah, so what I will do for this x square plus y square, I am using x equal to r cos theta. This is the value of x. Value of y will come r sin theta. Then what is the value of z?
Root under a square minus r square.
Then z will be square root of a square minus r square. So only two, because a and a is given here, so only two parameter r and theta. So this is the parametric representation of sphere. Is that clear to everyone? I will give one more parametric representation of sphere apart from this. Okay. So I will give the another parametric representation of this same sphere. So this x and y are same. So instead of z, if I will put this x and y back to here in this sphere, what I will get? I will get r square plus z square equal to a square. And now I am taking the parametric representation of this r and z. Like here x square plus y square equal to something r square is coming. For this circle, the parametric representation will be x equal to a cos theta, y equal to a sin theta. So this is a kind of circle, radius a. Center 0, 0 in RZ plane. So can you give me the parameterization of R and Z for this circle? Yeah, so theta I already used here, so I'm not using the same theta, I'm using something else. Yeah, a cos pi, a sin pi. Or someone can take a sin pi this, a cos phi this. So this is the correct answer. X equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta, and z equal to a square square root of this. This is also correct. Now I am just giving the two more. X equal to x, y, z. I am giving one more. So x equal to r cos theta. This r, y equal to r sin theta, I put here, I got r square plus z square equal to a square. And from this, r equal to a cos phi, z equal to a sin phi, or r equal to a sin phi, r equal to a cos phi. So this a cos phi, if you replace here, instead of this r, because this is the value of r. So z equal to a sin phi. I'm doing for the first one. If z equal to a sin phi, then r equal to a cos phi, if r, I will put here, because x equal to r cos theta, so it will become a cos phi cos theta, y equal to a cos phi sin theta. So this is the parametric representation of the same circle, same sphere, in two parameters. The parameters are theta and phi. Is it clear?
So once again, explain.
Yeah, x equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta. I replaced into the sphere equation. The equation become r square plus z square equal to a square. Then again, I did r equal to a cos phi, r equal to a sin phi. This is the parametric representation of this circle, r square plus z square equal to a square. So I got r value and z value. But x, y is this one. So z is remain same. X value equal to r cos theta. So this r, I replace in place of r in x and y. So we got new x and y in terms of phi and theta. So this parameter r I eliminated. So only two parameter. Even we can take this also, r equal to a sin phi. Then we can replace here. It will give a sin phi cos theta, y equal to a sin phi sin theta, and z equal to a cos phi. That is also a parametric representation of the same sphere. Now the question is, what is, if this is the parametric representation, then what is the value of parameter, like parameter range? Phi will lie from where to where, and theta will go from where to where. suppose this one, for this what is the range of phi and theta? So can anyone tell where the phi and theta will lie?
Five from 0 to 2 pi.
Theta will lie from where to where? Phi
zero
from
to
0 to 2 pi and theta?
0 to 2 pi.
Both are 0 to 2 pi. But that is not the correct answer. So I will just draw the picture.
Sir, phi minus pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2.
Yeah, that we can take. So I'm just putting this three dimension. This is x, this is z, and this is y. So I will just draw this sphere. So sphere is something like this in 3D. So when we are doing for x and y, this theta, and this one is for r and z, this theta is definitely from 0 to 2 pi. When we did x equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta. But once we are taking this phi in rz plane, not in xy plane. So if you take this point here in the sphere, then this angle is phi from the z axis, because z is involved here. So that angle cannot be 360. See, theta equal to 0 to 2 pi means it will, this circle in the center at 0 comma 0 and radius as a, this circle whatever I draw, x square plus y square equal to a square. This circle, it will run from theta equal to 0 to 2 pi. But that circle, once it will go on the top of the sphere, its radius will become 0. It will go bottom of the sphere, also its radius will become 0. So like that, we are generating this sphere. So think in that way.
0 to 2 pi, sir.
So this x square plus y square equal to a square, that is the circle, and this z, if z equal to 0, that means at the location of this origin, like here if you put z equal to 0, you will get the circle x square plus y square equal to a square, right? So z equal to 0, then circle will come at the center, this x square plus y square equal to a square. But when z equal to a, because this sphere has a radius a, when z equal to a, at that means this height, then this circle will go up and its radius will become 0. Because if z equal to a, then a square and a square will cancel out and it will give 1 point. Similarly, at the bottom, it will go in the minus a direction. Then also minus a, if you put z equal to minus a, then also that circle will become the 0 radius. So the circle is moving from minus a to plus a. So like someone already told that one, this x equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta, in that notation, in that parametric representation, if you take this x equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta, and z equal to something like this, a square minus r square. Then here r lies from 0 to 1, theta lies from 0 to 2 pi. But in this notation, this phi came in the picture. So phi can be from 0 to pi only. It cannot be 360. Otherwise, the points will repeat again. So like 0 to 2 pi, the half part of the circle will cover, and once will from 0 to 2 pi, whole sphere will come. So here phi from 0 to pi and theta from 0 to 2 pi. Phi means this angle. Suppose this is the point, the angle from the z axis. So from z axis means it will start from 0, it will go up to minus z. That means the half part of this will cover. But once you will rotate with the theta 0 to 2 pi, that means the whole sphere will cover. So this is the parametric representation where phi and theta, phi lies from 0 to pi and theta lies from 0 to 2 pi. Can you give me the parametric representation for this cylinder? X square plus y minus 3 whole square equal to 9. Z lies from 0 to 5. So the if you draw like picture wise, so this is the suppose circle with center 0 and radius 0,3 and radius 3, and this is z equal to 5 and this is z equal to 0. So whatever picture I draw, this is the actual cylinder. So this is z equal to 0, that is z equal to 5. So can anyone give the parametric representation of this cylinder? So the same circle without changing the radius, moving from 0 to 5, because z is from 0 to 5. So it will generate a cylinder.
X equal to 3 cos theta, y equals to 3 plus 3 sin theta.
Yeah, so what I will do, I will just take this as a x, as a r cos theta, and this y minus, this is r sin theta. So if you will take x equal to r cos theta and y minus 3 equal to r sin theta, then what will be the value of r? Like x. X cos theta, this one. And y minus 3 equal to r sin theta. Then what will be the value of r?
3.
9.
Because
3.
So by putting this both, I got the value of r. So that means the representation will be x equal to 3 cos theta. Definitely theta lies from 0 to 2 pi. And y will come. This is minus 3 will go that side. 3 plus 3 sin theta. And z is, you can take any parameter. Suppose I took z as a t, where t lies from 0 to 5. So this is the parametric representation of the cylinder. Two parameter, one is theta, another parameter is t. T lies from 0 to 5, and this theta lies from 0 to 2 pi. Like we have seen in the single parameter case, the length of this curve, that is the derivative of this square root, and then you will be able to calculate the length. Now we will see the area of this surface, and this is the formula for area of the surface. If surface is given in the parametric form with two parameter u comma v, so this ru will represent the tangent direction, the derivative of r with respect to u. Rv will represent, that is also another tangent direction, derivative with respect to v. Both exist and are continuous. Then this cross product, suppose it is not zero, that means that will not intersect, and that itself, that surface. So this ru cross rv will be the normal to this ru vector and rv vector. So its norm du dv, and u, suppose u range is from a to b and v range is from c to d, then if you integrate this double integral, then you will get the area of this surface. Like we are calculating length in the one single parameter, something similar to that is the surface area in two parameters. So now this can also be represented. This is by Thomas' book. They are following this notation d sigma. D sigma means this one, norm of ru cross rv du dv. The question is find the surface area of this cone. So first we'll write the parametric representation, and then by using this one we can calculate this, using this formula we can calculate the surface area. So what is the parametric representation of this? X equal to
3 cos theta.
Yeah, just now we have seen x equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta, and z equal to r. Theta lies from 0 to 2 pi. And r from 0 to 1. So now I will use the formula for surface area. That is the double integral. Here norm of. So this r will be matching with this r. So I am just changing this r is something different. Suppose this is t. So that there is no confusion. So this means t lies from 0 to 1. So this is the parametric representation with two parameter t and theta. So now in this formula, first you will differentiate this vector r. R means this one. So we'll differentiate this with respect to parameter u. Then we'll differentiate with respect to parameter v partially. And then we'll take the cross product and then we'll take the norm. We'll get this value. And then du dv and then apply the limit. We'll get the area. First I will write what is vector r. And then we'll do the differentiation to find the surface area. So what is vector r in this case? Vector r is this one, x, the first component t cos theta, t sin theta, and then t. This is r. Then we'll differentiate with respect to parameter t, it will give rt. Then we'll differentiate with respect to parameter theta, because here the parameter is theta, two parameter t and theta. So we'll differentiate with the parameter and we'll get rt, and then we'll find the cross product of this rt cross r theta, its norm, in order to apply that formula. So what is rt? Can anyone tell the partial derivative of this r with respect to t? Because it is vector valued function, so derivative means we have to do the component wise. So what is rt and r theta? Yeah, rt with respect to t, it will give cos theta. This one with respect to t will give sin theta. Then with respect to theta, if you differentiate, it will give minus t. The derivative of cos theta will give minus sin theta, then t cos theta, and then 0. So now what is the cross product of these two vectors? These are two three-dimensional vector, and you know how to do the cross product.
0. With respect to theta,
So now we'll do the cross product of rt cross r theta, because in this formula we need first derivative with respect to parameter and then take the cross product. Whatever it will come, we have to take the norm of this. That means the length of that vector, and then du dv. So here the parameter are not uv, u equal to I am taking as a t, and v I am taking as a theta. How to find the cross product? Can anyone tell how to find the cross product of two vector?
Determinant.
How to find the cross product of two? How to do? So two vector is given, a equal to this one, 3i cap plus 2j cap minus k cap, and the vector b is this one, I cap plus j cap plus k cap. Can you find a cross b?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So how to do a cross b?
Determinant.
Yeah. Determinant of what?
I j k 3 2 minus 1 1 1.
Yeah, so you know how to do cross product. So here two vector is there. This one is the 3, here 3 I cap, j cap, k cap. So here this is the ith component, this is the jth, and this is the kth component. And means what? It is written cos theta I cap plus sin theta j plus 1 into k cap. This means minus t sin theta I cap, t cos theta j cap, and this 0 means 0 times k cap. So now can you find what is the cross product? So the cross product of rt cross r theta will be the determinant of I j k, and then I j k component. The first one, rt component, cos theta, here it is sin theta, and this is 1. Then minus t sin theta, then t cos theta, and then 0. So do the calculation and tell me what will be the cross product of this.
Minus t cos theta I cap minus t sin theta j cap plus t k cap.
So minus t cos theta I cap, that is the first component. Then second component is
minus t sin theta, comma t.
Minus t sin theta.
Minus t sin theta. And comma the t. Third component?
T.
Comma t. So this is the cross product and that is also a vector. And here it is written norm of this. So what will be the norm of this? Square root of this is square plus this is square plus this is square. So what will become? The norm of rt cross r theta.
Root 2t.
So once we got this one, root 2t, then we'll find the surface areas. The surface area formula says that it is the integration of this cross du du. So I will write here. This one came root 2t. Then tell me which limit you want, the limit of t first or limit of a theta first. I will write that.
T.
So it is t and then theta. So t limit is 0 to 1. Theta from 0 to 2 pi. So the integration of t will come t square by 2. Then limit from 0 to 1. And then we will integrate with respect to theta. So it will give half. That means it will give 2 pi by root 2, I think, or root 2 pi. Just verify it is correct or wrong, that integration.
Yes, sir.
So that is the surface area. The next question is to find the surface area for a sphere. So can anyone tell without calculating, without using formula, what will be the surface area of a sphere?
4 pi a square.
Pi r cube is the volume, surface area. So here we can do by parameterization also we can do. So tell me which parameterization you want. Based on that we can calculate this surface area by using this formula. So first we have to write the parameterization or parametric equation for this sphere. What is x, y and z? Tell me x, y, z.
R cos theta, R sin theta.
R cos theta, R sin theta. Okay, this one you want. Okay, I will use this one. So tell me what is the this range of r and theta here.
0 to 1, 0 to 2 pi.
So here r form
0 to a.
0 to a, 0 to a, sir.
0 to a and theta from 0 to 2 pi. This one. Is it 0 to a or minus a to a? So if r equal to 0 to a, so if r equal to 0, what is the value of z?
That's a to a, because phi a. Is 0 to pi, na?
That's why I'm asking. See, here z is what? A square minus r square. If r is from 0 to a, then what is the value of z? Z range is from where to where?
A to 0.
Yeah, can z can be negative or not?
Yes sir.
In this sphere it can be negative. So if you are saying r from 0 to a, then this z is not valid. So whatever you are giving this parametric representation of this hemisphere, not like full sphere, only the positive part of the sphere, z from 0 to a,
then so we will multiply by 2.
Yeah, so if you want to do the surface area, then this two times that answer will come. So first you will find the surface area of hemisphere and then multiply by 2, then you will get the complete. But this is not the correct parameterization of this sphere. It is only for hemisphere. Okay, we'll do for this. That means we'll find the surface area. Yeah, that cos phi sin phi we can do that way. Both will give the correct answer, or we can do like this also, but two times you have to multiply if you are taking this parameterization of hemisphere. So tell me which way you want, this way or that way. Both will give the same answer anyway. You know the answer, 4 pi a square will come.
Sir, phi theta.
Okay, phi theta, no problem. So this way also two times you have to do. Then I will use that one. Phi theta you are saying, x, y, z. So tell me what is the z value is something, suppose a cos phi, then a sin phi will come here, and this is something cos theta, this is sin theta. So here if you do x square plus y square, you will get a square cos square theta sin square phi, and y equal to a square sin square theta sin square phi. If you add a x square plus y square plus z square, you will get a square only. So here the parameter are theta and phi. So what is the range of theta and what is the range of phi? This is 0 to 2 pi. So 0 to 2 pi, and this is 0 to pi only. So I'm using this parameterization to find the surface area. So for that we need R. We'll differentiate with respect to parameter, then we'll take the cross product. So R also component A cos theta sin phi, comma A sin theta sin phi, then z equal to a cos, then we'll differentiate with respect to theta, we'll differentiate with respect to phi, we'll find r theta cross product with the phi and this norm. So first calculate this norm, after that I will do the surface area. This one differentiate with respect to theta and then with respect to phi, and then take the cross product, find the norm, you will get some value. So this will give minus a sine theta sine phi a cos theta sine phi, and there is no theta, so 0. With respect to phi, it will give a cos theta cos phi a sine theta cos phi minus a sin phi. These two vectors applied in the determinant form, find the cross product, and then we have to find the norm of this also. So anybody got this now?
Sir, minus a square sine square phi cos theta I cap.
Product. Wait. Yeah, tell me minus.
Minus a square sine square phi cos theta I cap.
Sine square phi cos theta. Okay, this is the first component I cap. Then.
Then minus a square sine square phi sine theta j cap.
And the last one?
Minus a square sine phi cos phi k cap.
Minus a square sine?
Sine phi cos phi.
Sine phi cos phi. So everybody getting the same thing?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then we have to find the length of this.
Yes, sir.
That means the norm of this. You have to take square root of all those things. So here, if you take the square root, then this cos sine theta and sine square theta. Then this one will give sine square phi cos square phi. So what you will get?
A square sine square phi.
A square sine square phi.
Sorry, sir. A 4 sine square phi.
We have a square root also, so a square will come in the formula. This component is square, this component is square, this component, and then square root. So it will come a square only, right? So everybody getting this one or not? Is it okay? Then some surface area will be the integration of this cross product a square sine square phi. Suppose I will write d phi first and then d theta. Theta from 0 to 2 pi and this is from 0 to pi. So a square anyway common. So what is the integration of sine square phi from limit 0 to pi? Sine square phi you have to break into the terms of 1 plus 1 minus cos 2 pi by 2.
Sir, I think it is a square sine phi, the norm.
A square sine phi.
Yes, sir.
Then integration of sine phi will give cos phi. Then limit cos phi is, and then cos 0. What you will get. And then apply the limits for theta also.
Sir, screen is forced, move, not moves.
Hey, screen I am not moving. See, the integration of this sine phi from 0 to pi with respect to phi will be what?
2.
It will come 2 and then d theta. This theta will integration will come 2 pi, then it will become 4 pi a square. That is the surface area.